Alright, Moses Flotus, more commentary on Evi410's argumentation. Okay, more comments here. We got into some conversation regarding Greek at some point, using the Greek words. And she says, by the way, if scripture is sufficient, the knowledge of Greek should not be necessary. Perhaps you should teach sola scriptura and sola Greek. To which I responded, Evi, this is by far the most ridiculous comment I have heard from you. The New Testament was originally written in Greek, and it is the God-breathed language of the New Testament. English, I'm sorry, is not the language of the Spirit inspired, that the Spirit inspired the New Testament in. The translations of scripture to many languages contain some errors because some languages do not even have words or concepts that accommodate the Greek. Seriously, how can you assert this? Even Augustine wrote that some languages do no justice to the original languages. You know, to which I added at some point that the doctrine of sola scriptura doesn't say that the translations of scripture are God-breathed or anything like that, but rather we posit, as in the Westminster Confession of Faith, that the original autographs of scripture in their original languages, those are the God-breathed scriptures. The copies are not God-breathed, translations are not. And so again, Evi finds herself arguing against nothing and beating the air. Great job, she won. Awesome. Okay. Now, at some point she says, you say that scripture is enough and then say that a person must know Greek. Now, first of all, I'm going to have to challenge Evi to show me where I said that a person must know Greek in order to gain the sufficient knowledge of salvation. Again, as stated in an official document that describes sola scriptura to the teeth, that the most fundamental teachings, the sufficient teachings in order to be saved, are basically easily there to be grasped. Let me quote the Westminster, actually, and be a little bit be more precise in saying that. Here we go. The meanings of all passages in the Bible are not equally obvious, nor is any individual passage equally clear to everyone. However, everything which we need to know, believe, and observe in order to be saved is so clearly presented and revealed somewhere in the Bible that the uneducated as well as the educated can sufficiently understand it by the proper use of the ordinary means of grace. Regarding the languages of Scripture, this is chapter 1.8 of the Westminster Confession. The Old Testament in Hebrew, the native language of the ancient people of God, and the New Testament in Greek, the language most widely known internationally at the time of the New Testament was written, were directly inspired by God and have been kept uncontaminated throughout time by His special care and providence. They are, therefore, authentic and are to be the Church's ultimate source of appeal in every religious controversy. The original languages of the Bible, however, are not understood by all of God's people. But all of God's people have a right to and interest in the Bible, and God Himself commands them to read it thoroughly with awe and reverence for Him. Consequently, the Bible should be translated into the native language of every people to whom it is introduced. Then the Word of God will live fully in everyone. Everyone will be able to worship God in an acceptable way, and all believers may have hope through the endurance and the encouragement of the Bible. It's kind of interesting that it's the Protestants who encouraged more the translation of the Bible into other languages, while Rome says it should stay in the original Latin. I find that quite curious for several reasons. First of all, the Latin Vulgate is a translation of the Hebrew and Greek by Jerome, who was commissioned by Damasus essentially to give the Latin their official version. But I don't think that it was ever intended that the Latin was to be the Bible for people who don't speak Latin. That's obviously basically equivocates to speaking in tongues in the church. Don't do it if you're not going to translate it. You know, and I find it interesting that it's the Protestants essentially kind of following that pattern of bringing the gospel to people and letting them hear it in their own native languages. It's the Protestants who've done that the most. I like this quote that she says here. This was really interesting. Okay, so she says that it's not enough scriptures that I say scripture is enough and then say that a person must know Greek. I never, ever make that assertion, nor would I, that you have to know Greek. Obviously, I don't know Greek perfectly. Okay? She says, don't get mad at me for your contradiction. And I never said English was the language. In fact, I have already stated that the church says, there's the authoritative appeal, the church says the Latin Vulgate is the only inerrant Bible. Don't act as if I commented on the language. I'm commenting on your saying a person must know Greek after you said scripture is sufficient. Okay, here we go. So, if the Latin Vulgate is the only inerrant Bible, what of the Bible that was used to translate the Vulgate? Does that mean that the Greek and the Hebrew scriptures are errant? And that the Vulgate, an inerrant text, is based on an errant text? That doesn't seem to follow, does it? Doesn't seem to make much sense, really, to say that you can have an inerrant, infallible scripture that you basically translated from an errant text. What does that say about the Spirit's work in guiding the apostles when they wrote their letters? How can Paul or Peter refer to Paul's words as scripture? You know, did Peter know that the Latin was going to be the only inerrant text? How come the original manuscripts by the apostles, how come they weren't just written in Latin then? Why did God in his providence, in his wisdom, choose Greek? Question. I don't know. Why did he inspire the Hebrew people to write their text in Hebrew when God would know that the inerrant text was going to be the Latin Vulgate? Huh. Think about that one for a bit. The argumentation there, really, I mean, I can kind of see where some, you know, a lot of the Catholics are definitely saying, you know, Evie's out of whack, you know, again, which just proves the point, not all Catholics are united, okay? But seriously, I don't think that Evie is thinking through her comments. I think she's fishing for something to stay above water, and honestly, I think pride is coming in a real sort of way here. I think the scriptures are clear. If you really do believe that the scriptures are God-breathed revelation, as you say you do, Evie, that they are really God's word, then doesn't God speak, and when he speaks, he can speak to our level? When God uses things like grammar, to pen the text of scripture through the Spirit, inspired, directed through men and stuff, can God not do that? Can God not mean what he says? When God uses a past tense verb, can he not mean past tense? When he uses perfect tense, doesn't he mean perfect tense? Or if that's the case, I mean, really, what do the words of scripture mean? What does any language mean? I mean, we kind of find ourselves wrapped up in postmodernism here, that words can mean anything and everything, which means they mean absolutely nothing. I find it horribly convenient for Evie that whenever a clear meaning of Scripture says, what must I do to be saved? Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. There's nothing else in that text. When Paul tells the Philippian jailer, the jailer asks, in all sincerity, what must I do to be saved? And Paul only answers, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. I find it horribly convenient for Evie to be able to say, well, you also have to believe in the Marian dogmas and papal infallibility and in the authority of the church, the Eucharist, etc., 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 when that's not in Scripture. Again, Scripture is so clear that even the uneducated can see what they must do to be saved. And again, that is a statement of sola scriptura, that Scripture sufficiently contains what one must do to be saved. Yes, there are many other treasures in Scripture that can be unlocked through knowing culture, through knowing history, through knowing Greek, but the basics of what I need to do to be saved is sufficiently contained within Scripture that the educated and the uneducated alike can get. Of course, if Evie really knew what sola scriptura meant, she would certainly understand that.
Arrivederci, Roma. Goodbye, goodbye.